the Lord. God bless you in Jesus' name. Welcome to a fresh word with Apostle Samuel E. Malombe. If you're seeing me for the very first time on this platform, I share the word of God with you. I join you in prayers 2 times every day, 1 in the morning and in the evening. And I bring you a fresh prophetic word, instruction, direction from the throne of the Lord for you. Sounds like what you're interested in, please consider subscribing on this channel and just ringing the notification bell. God bless you in Jesus' name. I have a very serious prophetic word that God has dropped in my spirit. I've been resisting making this video, but the Lord kept bringing this word very, very strong in my heart, and I believe that this is a now word for somebody. It is very urgent. It's an urgent prophetic word. God says, don't say a word. Do not say a word because you are being monitored. God says, do not say a word. You are being monitored. The devil is not all-knowing. Satan is not all-knowing. He depends on information from conscious and unconscious agents. You know, the devil has 2 kinds of agents. He has conscious agents, people who know that they are working for the Satan, he is their boss. And then there are unconscious agents who do not actually know that they are within the framework of the devil's, you know, assignment. They are doing what the devil wants them to do. You know, he's just using them unconsciously. So there are always people around you that are monitoring spirits. There are a set of demons that are monitoring spirits. These people don't actually harm you. They don't do anything. They just pick up information. Just like in the realms of the spirit, there are angels whose only responsibility in heaven, I mean, there are angels whose only responsibility is to measure territories. We saw them in the book of Revelation. They only had a tape where they measured territories. They measure the territories that you have conquered. Measure the territories that have been taken up for Jesus. It is in the book of Revelation. There are specific demons that are called monitoring spirits. They do not harm you. They do not affect you. But they gather information. The Lord is telling me to tell somebody, this is how the information that has been used to attack you has been going out before. You easily discuss about the things that God has started to do in your life, even before it gets to fruition, even before it is fully conceived. God says, you should keep quiet about the things that he has started to do. When the Lord begins to lead you towards probably your kingdom spouse or giving you a new job or moving, please be careful about who you share this kind of information with, because you might not know the link that these people have spiritually. So you have to build an incubating womb. Every believer needs an incubating womb, a place where you store things, you intercede for them, you pray for them, and you do not talk about them until they actually come to fruition. So as I was saying, Satan operates by, you know, information that he has gathered through agents, conscious and unconscious agents. I hope you know that he's not omnipotent, he's not omniscient, and he's not omnipresent. What do I mean by that? Satan is not everywhere at the same time. Satan is not all-knowing, and Satan is not all-powerful. So the reason why you can see concentrated attacks over your life is because he senses that God is set to do something new in your life, or he gets the information, probably by prophecy or by you telling people what the Lord is just beginning to do in your life. So what do? You conserve it. You keep quiet about it. You stay quiet about it until God is done doing what he is doing. I have been pastoring for quite a while and have seen people who mess up a whole divine plan just because they couldn't wait for it to come to fruition. Hallelujah. Don't say a thing until they are mature. The Lord, as God was giving me this prophetic word, the Lord drew me to the story of Mary and Elizabeth. Mary was the earthly mother of Jesus, and Elizabeth was the mother of John the Baptist. Elizabeth was the mother of John the Baptist. As a matter of fact, before I get to the story of Elizabeth and Mary, the father of John the Baptist, who was Zechariah, was a priest of God. The Bible says that the angel appears and announces the good news, and guess what? He doubted, and the angel says, you are going to be mute. He would have said you'll be blind. He would have said you're going to stop being a priest. But he shut his mouth because he could have used his mouth, his doubting mouth, to say things that can puncture that divine prophecy. There is somebody watching me right now. The Lord says this is how the failures you have been experiencing actually came about. You spoke to somebody, you did not know that you were actually speaking to a conscious agent or an unconscious agent who actually carried this information to quarters where you were being attacked. And this is not only spiritually, even physically. You speak to people who are jealous, who are envious, who want to be in your position, who want to sit in the seat that you're sitting. And you think that they are your friends. You think that you're sharing information with somebody who should be happy with you, whereas they are just wishing that they could be in your position. So the angel told him, you will be mute. That is very important. Now, back to Mary and Elizabeth. The Bible says that Elizabeth was pregnant and she said nothing, said to nobody. As a matter of fact, when Mary also got pregnant, the Bible says that she conceived the pregnancy. She hid the pregnancy. It was something to, you know, ponder about, not to go about and tell everybody, put it on your social media status, hi, an angel just appeared to me and told me that I will carry a holy seed and all that and all that. You do not know who is watching. You do not know who is listening. Make sure you celebrate the victories. Make sure you celebrate victories for when the battle is already completed. You do not celebrate the victory in the middle of the battle. You celebrate the victory when the battle is completed. Your story will make more sense when your miracle is complete. Please, this is a very important prophetic word that God is trying to save you from another attack, because God is set to do something new in your life. He's set to give you an amazing, amazing second, third, or fourth, whatever the chance is. And the Lord is saying, do not say a word because you are being monitored. Hallelujah. So what do? There are things that, number one, you must build the capacity to incubate what the Lord has spoken to you. If God says something to you, and mind you, sometimes it can be so exciting, the things that the Lord says to you, you can want to share it with somebody, but you must understand that if you must share it, it must be with your Elizabeth, somebody who has the same spirit. The Bible says that Elizabeth also was pregnant with a holy child. And when Mary encountered Elizabeth, Elizabeth says, the baby in my womb leaped for joy when you encountered me. So when you speak to somebody that God has already spoken to in the same magnitude or in a higher magnitude, they will be able to mentor you on what you must do. But when you speak to somebody who God has not spoken to, has not given the same level of grace that he has accorded to you, you are just attracting battles upon yourself. Family, this is so important. What I'm sharing with you right now is so important. If you say anything, it should be to someone who can pray with you and not somebody who can discuss about you. You need somebody who can encourage you and not somebody who can gossip about you. You need somebody who can stand with you, sharpen your countenance when you are down, not somebody who will compete with you and look at you as a threat to their existence. Hallelujah. So simply put, the Lord is saying that he is set to do something in your life in 2022. He's set to give you the opportunities that you've lost before, but this time do not say a word because you are monitored. Would you let me pray for you right now? Would you let me just invoke the grace of God upon your life and to pray the wisdom of God to help you guide your affairs in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for your child that is watching right now. Give them the wisdom to run their lives. Give them the wisdom to stand in that point where, Lord, everything that you have spoken to them will come to fruition before the world can see it. In the name of Jesus. Amen. The Lord bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Please, if you got value from this video, please be the reason why we grow. Please join the family by subscribing, by ringing the notification bell, and always leave a comment so that I know where you're connected from and how the word resonates with you. I love you so much. God bless you.